Good morning, this is Dave Pearson and my wife Evelyn. Welcome to the program that seeks to encourage and lift your spirit. In today's world, we can conquer any obstacles in life, no matter what they might be, through the power of the love of God. Stay with us. You'll be blessed, challenged, and inspired by God's message of hope. Good morning, everyone. This is Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn. I'm Dave, and my beautiful wife, Evelyn, is right here in the studio.
And good morning. We welcome all of our listeners, whether you're listening to us on the radio in the Chicagoland area or listening to us on the internet from some part of the world. Welcome all.
Psalms 119:105 tells us that the Word of God is a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path. Lonnie Liston Smith opens us up with the divine light. Lonnie Liston Smith doing Divine Light. So I thought that would be a good one for us this morning to have a great start with our broadcast today. Well, welcome. And as you know, this is a biblical approach to life in Christ. We look at the scripture of different themes. We call it thematic, right, Evelyn?
Mm-hmm.
Well, here's our topic for you today. What are we to do for one another as Christians?
Yes, that expression, one another, is used frequently in Scripture. We're working from a compilation by Pastor Charles Butler of the Moody Church. And that was a question he asked one Wednesday evening. What are we to do for one another as Christians? So we have worked through the list using verses from the English Standard Version. And it's a wonderful study that we're going to go through today.
Love one another. Romans 12:10. Love one another with brotherly love or affection. Outdo one another in showing honor.
So clearly, God expects us, this one another relationship that we have as Christians, to be different.
Almost a competition going on here, Evelyn. Outdo one another or go out of your way to show some kindness to someone. That's what I get from this as well, Romans 12:10.
Yes, and that's very different to trying to compete with other people to show more honor to them than you're getting yourself.
Yeah.
So, wow, that would be quite different. 1 Thessalonians 4:9. Now, concerning brotherly love, you have no need for anyone to write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love one another. And Jesus, of course, taught that when he was on earth. He said that he wanted all men to know that we are his disciples for a love for one another. And here, the writer Paul is saying that the Thessalonians have been taught by God to love one another. And he said that that's exactly what they're doing for the brothers throughout Macedonia.
That's right. God tells us to love one another. You know, the world may out-finance us, the world may out-entertain us, but let it never be said they'll out-love us. This is the badge of the Christian. This is one of the first and greatest commandments, to love one another. I like verse 11, sweetheart, where it says, aspire to live quietly and mind your own business. And so, wow, it's a mouthful, verse 11. Well, 1 Peter 1:22.
Having purified your souls by your obedience to the truth for a sincere brotherly love, love one another earnestly from a pure heart.
I love this because in the very beginning of this verse it says, having purified your souls first, then you'll be able to love one another earnestly.
Mm. And how do you purify your souls? By your obedience to the truth. Wow.
Yep.
I love that. Earnestly, your love should be earnest from a pure heart.
I got intense, earnestly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 1 Peter 4:8. Above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers a multitude of sins. So I get from this, keep on keeping on.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. And keep forgiving one another over and over and over, because love covers a multitude of sins. So if you've sinned greatly, you need to love greatly. All right.
1 John 3:11. For this is the message that you have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. So sort of a first principles of Christianity, of relationships between Christians, is that to love one another. We should love one another.
You know, any act of kindness that we do towards someone is a demonstration of love. I tell my karate students all the time that, you know, children, you see some grandma coming up to the door at McDonald's or some restaurant and, you know, hold the door for her. And it's just going to be such a wonderful blessing and a testimony of showing love and kindness towards someone. And then she'll slip you a 20 and everything will be great. Just, it's a joke. No, she won't. But any act of kindness, you think, well, how can I show love? Show some kindness, letting someone out in front of you in the car, you know, in traffic, or holding the door for someone, some simple smile, anything like that is showing the love of God.
1 John 3:23, and this is his commandment, that we believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he has commanded us. So again, being taught by God to love one another, so it's coming from God the Father, that first we believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another. It's very fundamental to your faith.
Yeah, you know, this is what I get from this as well, Evelyn. God doesn't say it would be nice if you loved one another or you should love one another. No, it's a command. Love one another. And it's not optional. Then you have 1 John 4:7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God. And whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. So it's no surprise. For love is from God, because God is love, and he's our teacher.
Again, it's this integral part of your faith. Love is from God, and that's where we should love one another. And whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. And 1 John 4:11 again addressing the beloved. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another.
That's right. God loved us first. And then that's why I should love others. 1 John 4:12. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us.
So all part of that relationship. God lives in us if we love one another, and his love is perfected in us. I like that, Dave. It's perfected in us.
That's right. There's no half response, no half loves going on here. It's perfected. It's full love. That's right. 2 John 5.
And now I ask you, dear lady, not as though I were writing you a new commandment, but that we have had from the beginning, that we love one another. So this basically is, this set of instruction that we're reading here is clearly, it's one of the first principles. It's from the beginning that we love one another. So it shouldn't be new. And as we walk in the faith, it should be something that when we're told to love one another, it's something that we already know. God has taught us that we should do that. And again, such a richness that we can have in this love for others. And hopefully we can, the First Thessalonians, they were told to continue to do this more and more. And so that's something we need to do. Like you said, Dave, keep on keeping on.
Well, just remember, dear friend, before we go to a break, love is more powerful than hate. And I think it's really the key of why Jesus said love one another, because it's all about getting along. And how do we do that? Love. So we need to up our love game. We'll be right back after this. Hi, this is Dave.
And Evelyn Pearson.
We host a radio program here on AM 1160 WYLL every Saturday morning from 8 to 9 a.m. It's called Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn.
The program surveys the Bible and plays beautiful music to address a weekly theme.
Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn seeks to bless, challenge, and inspire its listeners to a closer walk with God and to trust Him for every aspect of their lives.
We have launched a website to enrich your experience in listening to our program, www.saturdayswithdaveandevelyn.org.
The website will include the previous week's broadcast and information including Bible verses for the upcoming program.
We have included some of our most popular programs, Building Self-Esteem God's Way and Conquering Condemnation.
From the website, you can contact us directly with program comments or suggestions, as well as advertising and sponsorship interest.
And link to our Facebook, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Google+, and Twitter pages.
Visit us on our website today, www.saturdayswithdaveandevelyn.org. Good morning, everyone. This is Pastor Dave Pearson, and my beautiful wife Evelyn's right here in the studio with me. We're doing a program on how is a Christian supposed to love one another, and that's a great study for us. And Whitley Phipps has a great song for us. It's called If I Can Help Somebody. Listen to these words and let them minister to your heart.
If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or a song, if I can show somebody traveling wrong, then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. As I pass
That was Whitley Phipps' beautiful song, If I Can Help Someone. Is there someone in the reach of your influence, dear friend, that you can help today? That's what we're talking about. Encourage them with these words that we're about to read from God's Word about what are we to do for one another as Christians.
That's interesting, Dave. It was a different perspective to go through your day thinking, can I help somebody? So if I could help somebody.
And we can. Mm-hmm. Well, let's continue our talk on how as a Christian to respond to one another. Treat each other well.
Well, that makes sense. If we're supposed to love one another, we should be treating each other well.
Ephesians 4:32 has to be mentioned here. Be kind, tender-hearted, forgiving one another. Wow, be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. So I get from this, Evelyn, that you can't really be tender-hearted and not forgive. You know what I mean? You have to be tender-hearted. It leads to a willingness to forgive one another. Why? Because Christ forgave us first.
So again, we're getting our instruction from God, the example of God, that God in Christ forgave us. So we should forgive one another. The verse also teaches us to be kind to one another.
Here's another one. Submit to one another. Ephesians 5:21.
Ooh, that submit word again. So against our nature. And it's kind of picking up from a passage that's from verses 18 to 21. But verse 21 says, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. So the reason we would submit to one another is because we revere Christ. Out of respect for Christ, our love for Christ, we would submit to one another. And wow, that would really change the way that we get along, Dave.
That's it. Thank the Lord. Well, seeking to do good, 1 Thessalonians 5:15. See that no one repays anyone evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to everyone. So I'm reminded right away, sweetheart, I put it down here, Romans 12:21. don't be overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good.
Wow, and that really, that song that you selected for this segment, Dave, goes right in there, right along with this. Seek to do good. Always seek to do good to one another and to everyone. And so that song, of course, was If I Can Help Somebody by Wintley Phibbs. And so, again, just need to have that orientation, sort of like you're on alert as you're going through your day, seeking to do good to one another, to other believers, but also to everyone that you come in contact with. Again, that'll transform your life, and what a different person we'll each will be to get along with if that's the way that we're doing it.
You know, I get from this as well where it says, don't repay anyone evil for evil. So do good even if you've been treated poorly. What a tall order that is. And it has to be Spirit-led. Lord, please give me the patience, your love to be shining here, even when I've been done wrong and I'm treated unfairly.
That's teaching of Jesus, right? We're to love those who persecute us and despitefully use us. Again, extremely transformational. Again, people will be able to tell that you're a Christian. And again, especially if we're doing this out of reverence for Christ.
And what happened to Jesus on the cross was unfair. And it's not easy for us to let people off the hook when they've done us wrong. So like you said, sweetheart, it's so great that Jesus is our great example.
Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person has great power as it is working.
Well, here again, talking about confessing our faults one for another, or our sins, there has to be an honesty here. And what I get from this as well, sweetie, is that it heals.
I really like the simplicity of this teaching.
It is. It's straightforward. Absolutely.
This relationship, what are we to do for one another as Christians? And here, pray for one another. I just love that. And it really touches my soul when someone tells me that they've been praying for me. You know, they're thinking, it's like you're walking in someone else's shoes. You're really thinking about what does that person need, and praying for them, lifting them up before the Father, going boldly to the throne of grace, praying for them. And I just love the second sentence in this verse, the prayer of a righteous person has great power as it is working. And so it's just fantastic when someone says, I've been praying for you. And I just had that happen to me this week. Someone texted me and just said, I'm praying for you, which is very encouraging. So how do we treat each other? We are to pray for one another.
Another portion of Scripture says, the prayers of a righteous man accomplishes much. And I get that as well from this.
Mm-hmm. So, that's from the King James Version, yeah. I love, again, it's just so powerful to think that prayer works.
Mm-hmm. Showing hospitality, 1 Peter 4:9, showing hospitality to one another without grumbling. Oh.
I love that little caveat
without grumbling. You know, and I have to mention this because this is so key about our spiritual walk. A person that cannot control his mouth, that person's religion is in vain. And so we have to act in such a way that we're not grumbling, right?
And really, do you really feel like somebody's showing you hospitality if they're grumbling?
Yeah. Like you're pushing them with a wheelchair and you're going, I have to do this for them. You know how heavy you are?
Yeah. So really, let's leave the grumbling out if you're trying to show hospitality.
Yeah. Okay. Serve one another with care. 1 Corinthians 12:25.
And again, this is from a passage that starts in 22 about the parts of the body. But it says that there may be no division in the body, but that the members may have the same care for one another. So again, equally treatment for the members of the body. So we should be treating people and giving them the same care.
Mm. Galatians 5:13 talks about how we should respond to others. And it says,
for you were called to freedom, brothers. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another. Wow. Again, this is the rubber hits the road. We're supposed to be serving one another. Not easy. The submitting and serving, like you said, showing hospitality without grumbling. These are very quite different.
It's a loving service, dear friend, as we're looking at this. Galatians 5:13. Well, we're going to get ready for a break and hope you stay with us. We're talking about what are we to do for one another as Christians. We'll be right back.
Keep up your guard for Christ, says Reverend Dave Pearson, a fifth-degree black belt in karate who uses biblical principles and martial arts to teach students to develop a physical and spiritual guard. Are you looking for a Christian-based martial arts program? There may be one near you. Masters Academy has 9 locations in the Chicagoland area.
Hi, this is Karate Dave. I've been teaching in the Chicagoland area for over 20 years, and my course details include basic self-defense training with Christian living applications and weekly Bible challenge and prayer to inspire a closer walk with Christ.
This unique system of martial arts unites Tangsudo Karate, Judo, Jiu-Jitsu Sport Karate, and street survival techniques that provide a fast, effective method of self-defense.
Come visit the class for yourself and find out why so many Christian families have made Masters Academy the believer's choice. Call today, 630-567-9188. Visit my website at karatedave.org.
Welcome back with us. This is Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn, and we're talking about what are we to do for one another as Christians. One of the ways is that we can be a great example. Once we've found Jesus Christ as our Savior, we've really traded our sorrows into joy. And now we can share that same joy with others.
that was Trading My Sorrows.
And that was the Chapel Choir and Orchestra, a group of high school students from First Baptist Church of Dallas. And that is from their album 2009, their Chicago tour.
And we met them before, and they are really good. I love their talent. Well, we're continuing on at Galatians 6:2. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
I so love that, Dave. Again, just a very simple instruction, but it's fulfilling the law of Christ to bear one another's burdens. And I think it goes very well with the song. We certainly need to be there when somebody's in sorrow, that we're helping them to bear their burden. And again, looking at other ways to serve one another. 1 Peter 4:10, as each has received a gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's varied grace. So just beautiful there. Each of us has a gift. Let's use it to serve one another.
Honor one another. Romans 12:10b. Outdo one another in showing honor. Wow. So I described honor this way. And parents with children, this is a great thing. And you walk into a room and you go, wow, I can't believe I'm in the same room with you. How special. You know, that kind of thing. It's like honoring them. Or, this is so great that we get to do something together. You know, I'm honored to be with you. That's a great thing. Say that to someone next time, in genuineness, of course, and they'll be blessed.
And I love this, outdo one another in showing honor. So it's almost like a competition in our Christian faith that who can show the most honor to someone else? Who's showing honor to? So we must really work at this.
Romans 12:16, live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Never be wise in your own sight. So I looked up the word haughty. Really, the only thing I got, and it was sort of like an old-fashioned term, looking down on the riffraff in life. So, when was the last time you used the word riffraff? But anyway, haughty, looking down on someone.
Which dictionary did you use? That's right. Do not be haughty, do not be puffed up, but associate with the lowly and never be wise in your own sight. And, of course, the instruction for one another is to live in harmony with one another, honoring others in the faith and not trying to make divisions or castes within the faith, trying to honor them and live in harmony with them.
And another one is encourage one another. Comfort, 2 Corinthians 13:11.
Finally, brothers, rejoice. Aim for restoration. Comfort one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you.
I love that. And then the God of love and peace will be with you if you live this way.
What a great outcome. Rejoice, aim for restoration, comfort one another, agree with one another, live in peace.
And then sing songs, Ephesians 5:19.
Addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart. So, wow.
And do that together. That's right.
Yeah, it makes you wonder about your communication. Am I doing that? Am I communicating in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with my heart?
Yeah, we do this. When we read these things together, dear friend, just want to let you know that we try to apply this as well. And it does. It raises the bar of our service one to another. 1 Thessalonians 4:18.
Therefore, encourage one another with these words. And that, of course, is the passage where it's talking about what's going to happen, how we're going to hear that trumpet sound, and those who are alive first will be caught up together with those who have gone before.
I love that song, coming again, coming again. It may be morning, it may be noon, it may be evening. He's coming soon. So encourage one another with these words. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. So there's no room here for put-downs. Build each other up. And there's the same thing about not going back with grumbling. Build each other up.
And that really, that's a visualization that's really strong for me, Dave, to think about. Are you building someone up? Are you propping someone up, helping them to be stronger and higher? Or are you tearing them down? So a real strong imagery here We're to encourage one another and build one another up.
And then ask yourself, in my relationship with these people, did I just leave them encouraged or not? And that's just a fair question. I've asked that myself. How did I just leave that person? And were they still upset, or were they now at peace because I was able to encourage them with a spirit of love? Yeah. Exhort. And that would be found in Hebrews 3:13. But exhort one another every day, as long as it's called today, that none of you may be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. Wow.
So, as long as it's today, we should be exhorting one another. And it's something we do every day. Okay, again, that encouraging, that building someone up.
Hardened, I got here. Calloused. You need some lotion.
Bring some lotion with you, huh?
Yeah.
That's right. So that's the outcome. That's the desired outcome, is that no one would be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin.
Mm-hmm.
So there's some spiritual instruction in there.
And how about Hebrews 10:25?
Not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. So encouraging others and then fellowshipping with them, spending time with them, so important.
Well, you think of the day drawing near. What do you think, dear friend, when we look at the world stage? Is it coming soon? I think so. And we'll be going to a break now, and hope you stay with us. We're continuing our talk on what are we to do for one another as Christians. Hi, this is Dave.
And Evelyn Pearson.
We host a radio program here on AM 1160 WYLL every Saturday morning from 8 to 9 a.m. It's called Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn.
The program surveys the Bible and plays beautiful music to address a weekly theme.
Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn seeks to bless, challenge, and inspire its listeners to a closer walk with God and to trust Him for every aspect of their lives.
We have launched a website to enrich your experience in listening to our program, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org.
The website will include the previous week's broadcast and information including Bible verses for the upcoming program.
We have included some of our most popular programs, Building Self-Esteem God's Way and Conquering Condemnation.
From the website, you can contact us directly with program comments or suggestions, as well as advertising and sponsorship interests.
And link to our Facebook, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Google+, and Twitter pages.
Visit us on our website today, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org. Good morning, everyone. This is Saturdays with Dave and Evelyn, and we're talking about what are we to do for one another as Christians. And I think of this song as a great song for helping others, and that's shining for the Lord Jesus. When you think about shining for the Lord, it's really shining in a world of darkness. And Christians are to be the light of the world because Jesus is. So let's shine for the Lord.
Shine on me.
Shine, Jesus, shine.
That's right. That was Graham Kendricks from the Best Worship Songs Ever album. So shine, Jesus, shine. And as Dave was saying before the song, he needs to shine through us.
Well, years ago, when I was on my 19th birthday, my dad gave me something about shining for the Lord. My 19th birthday happened to be my golden birthday when I was born in 1961. And he gave me this phrase about shining for the Lord. May your backbone be like iron for what you stand for. May your heart be soft as cotton, your compassion for others. And may your light never go out for others as well. So that's encouragement from my dad when I was 19 on the 19th.
That was a candle holder, right?
He designed it, yes.
Mm-hmm. Good. So we are looking at this question of what are we to do for one another as Christians? We are searching the Bible to see what it has to say. And basically, David, we've seen that there's a lot that we're taught to do for one another. But one of the things that we're taught is to instruct one another. And I love the passage from Hebrews 10:24. It says, "And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works."
So when I think of stirring up, you know, stirring me up to anger, stirring me up to some anxiety or whatever. But then, no, this is a different kind of stirring up. This is for good, not for anger, but up, stirring each other up for love and good works. Wow.
Another thing, of course, is to welcome one another.
Welcome one another as Christ has also welcomed you.
For the glory of God, mm-hmm. It says in Romans 15:7.
And greet one another. Romans 16:16. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the churches of Christ greet you.
And similarly in 1 Peter 5:14, greet one another with the kiss of love. Peace to all of you who are in Christ. So that's a nice tradition to greet each other with a kiss, a holy kiss or kiss of love.
Bear with one another. 1 Corinthians 11:33.
And that's the passage which is teaching us about how we should behave during communion service. It says, "So then, my brothers, when you come together to eat, wait for one another." So there may be some people who are hungry, so we should be eating at home so that when we come together, it will not be for judgment. So bear with one another, being patient and waiting.
Ephesians 4:2 talks about love.
With all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love.
Eager to maintain the unity of spirit and the bond of peace, a bond that can't be easily broken. Mm-hmm. That's great. Good stuff, Evelyn.
Colossians 3:13, forgiving. Bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. So that bearing with one another.
Agree with one another. 2 Corinthians 13:11. Comfort one another. Agree with one another. Live in the peace of God, and love and peace will be with you.
And there's a handful of things that it specifically says we should not do to one another.
Do not pass judgment. Romans 14:13.
Therefore, let us not pass judgment on one another any longer, but rather decide never to put a stumbling block or hindrance in the way of a brother.
And then do not grumble, James 5:9.
Do not grumble against one another, brothers, so that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing at the door.
Show hospitality without grumbling, 1 Peter 4:9.
That's right. Show hospitality to one another without grumbling.
Confess your sins. James 5:16. Therefore, confess your sins one to another and pray for one another that you may be healed.
That's right. And that's, wow. that's not easy to do.
Right. I got from that a clean slate and having no offenses. Huge to live in love for one another. Amen. Well, dear friend, we've been talking about how we can get along with each other as Christians. But how is your relationship with God Himself? There's three things God wants you to know today. He loves you very much, and He wants a wonderful relationship with you, and He has a great plan for your life. All you need to do is believe in Jesus Christ, confess your sins, and invite Him into your life, and He'll save you. And then you too can know what it's like
to love one another as Christ loved us. Let's pray. Lord, thank you so much for your word, how it's a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path in this dark world. I pray that you would help us to be people of love because you loved us. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, until next time, this is Pastor Dave and my beautiful wife, Evelyn. God bless you.
Thank you for being with us today. We hope it was an encouragement to you. If you're interested in a biblical approach to life in Christ, today's lesson is available to you. Visit our website, www.SaturdaysWithDaveAndEvelyn.org, or you may call Pastor Dave and Evelyn at 630-567-9188. Until next time, this has been Evelyn and Dave Pearson. May God's richest blessings be yours in the coming week.